Here we will finish up the indentations and work extensively with fillets. We'll come back through later and add fillets to this to soften it up. But let's do the same sort of operation from the top. Let's go straight to a top view, say done on the previous operation, create a new sketch, draw some arcs. This will also be just a visual, artistic kind of thing. And I'll draw in another arc. And then I can switch to a line to just close up this sketch. This part of it doesn't need to be pretty. Exit the sketch as I did before. Select the sketch from the list. Shift select the top face. And from this selection, I should have the project available to me. I can see the preview on top. Click done. Offset this face down by 0.01. While hidden edges are turned on, I should mention that you can select hidden edges while that setting is turned on. This makes it very convenient for things like fillets and other times when you have to select edges that you can't see. So let's turn that off. We're going to add a construction axis, change the type to perpendicular to face at point, and we'll say perpendicular to this face at this point. And just make sure it got the right thing. Now we will use the transform, rotate around the axis, select the items to rotate this face, next, and select the axis to rotate around. So one we just created. And now we can click the arrow. 5 is too much, so we'll make it 1.5. We'll say done. Let's also turn off some of these axes because we don't need those and they will just become distracting. When you put fillets on a model, it is the best practice to put the large fillets on first, and then the smaller fillets will go over those. So let's try to set up the fillets so that any secondary fillets we create will flow around the first fillets that we create. To me, this means that we're going to take this edge and pull a large fillet on here. Remember that each time you select an individual edge and use the arrow, it adds an item to your history tree. This could be good or it could be bad. We could have gone into this fillet and instead of just selecting a single edge, we could have selected multiple edges. But then all of the edges selected for that fillet would have to have the same radius value. You can see what's happening here. In this case, I really didn't want this lower fillet to have the same value. I wanted a smaller one. So I'm going to undo that and just let this fillet go back to having a single edge. And now we'll create a separate fillet on this edge and make it a little bit smaller. We'll just key in around 1 inch. Now if I select this edge and add a fillet here, we'll probably want to make it smaller because if it gets larger, it will start to fail in these corners when it's going around the other fillet. And that's fine. Another fillet back here. We're going to have to be careful because there's a slight step in here. And this will cause some difficulty probably. So if I create this fillet, you can see down here what happens if one fillet value exceeds the fillet value of the one that it's going over. It starts to create some funky corners. So it's best if you keep subsequent fillets at a smaller size. If you need to reorder the fillets in order to get that, that's okay. That's one of the advantages of history-based modeling, is that you can reorder features. Okay, so we've got these. Let's put a fillet across here. Let's also put some fillets in these corners. And let's select all of these at the same time. So I'm going to shift select this and this. And remember, I said that you can use the show hidden edges to select edges. And let's just get into a view where we can do that. So I can shift select this edge. So we can take these three and put nice fillets on them. All of these corners are going to have the same radius. From here, I'll select this edge and shift select that edge. And pull fillets on those. Select here, shift select up here, and okay, I'm running into an issue here. It says operation failed because the resulting body wouldn't be valid. It was giving me a different error message earlier. So sometimes when things fail, you try a different approach. So I'll try a different edge. And you see that this only goes away around part way. I'll create the fillet to begin with, and it's giving me an error here. So I'm going to control select another edge. Sometimes selecting more edges will help this work. Okay, that worked. Now I'm going to add to that fillet because I want them all to be together. I'll add edges from this feature up here. And let's click done. See if that works or if it gives us an error. No, that worked well. So we've got fillets that go all the way around. We rounded out those indentations very nicely. Follow along as we add more detail in the next video.